So very good morning to all the students of class plus 1B. Yes, beta, today we are going to do this writing skill, debate writing. Okay, so firstly, I will discuss all the value points about the content, about the format while sharing the screen. And then we will also write on the blackboard and you also keep noting down side by side. Okay, so let's have a look. What is debate writing? Though you have done this writing skill in junior classes also, but when you are in class plus one, we expect a very embellished vocabulary, fine, very formal language, and very solid points, fine, while writing the debate. What is debate writing? Debate writing is a formal discussion on a particular matter in a public meeting or legislative assembly. But it is not a correct definition, because we are going to do this debate as a writing skill. Okay. Otherwise, debate is like when there is some discussion going on by presenting the facts about a topic, and one party will agree to that topic, the other party will disagree to the same topic. So in that way, debate is that. But in our English subject, debate here is, we are going to do it as one of the writing skills. So whatever we are going to write, either in favor or against the topic given to us. Okay. In writing section, debate writing comes as a long answer type question. So it carries 10 marks. Fine. 10 marks. So it's, you can say, you can get a 10 on 10 if you are writing in a beautiful way, keeping in view all the points. Now let's discuss some tips. The first and the foremost step is to choose the side, whether you want to write for or against the motion. Now, beta, if the topic is given to you and it is mentioned that write in the favor of the topic, then you will write in the favor of the topic. But if it is mentioned that write against the topic, then you will write against the topic. But if nothing is mentioned, it is just mentioned that write a debate, yes, beta, can you hear me? There was some connectivity issue. That's why it happened. Voice is audible, beta? So you have to choose that side in which you have more information. You can write more points. Whether you agree or disagree, that's a separate. Beta, tell me, am I audible to you all? Am I audible, children? Again and again, network is coming and going just like yesterday. Aditi, Mitali, awaaz aa rahi hai beta aapko? Yes, beta, can you hear me? Due to internet connection is unstable again today. So that's why that it is disconnecting again and again. Fine. So we were discussing, now it's audible, then let's continue. So I will be, you know, increasing the speed so that jitna ho jaye connection mein. Introduction, you will be introducing yourself, the topic, and then favor or against, then whether you're going to speak against the motion or favor the motion. Then you will discuss in second paragraph, you will discuss the problem, okay, by using particular jargons, particular words meant for debate only. I will be discussing each and everything in detail on the board. Fine, when I will write on the board, even then if voice goes, you will be able to see the screen at least. Fine, so please stay. Then solution of the problem in next paragraph, we will discuss what can be done to break the problem, to get the solution. And finally, the fourth paragraph will be the conclusion, where we will be concluding the ideas, whatever mentioned above. Okay. So let us discuss each of them in detail. Firstly, we will do the introduction. This includes salutations and topic, including for or against the motion. For example, now see, please read this. Drishti, please read this, what I have highlighted. Drishti, if you are there. Yes, beta.
Good morning, everyone, esteemed judges, honorable guests, respected teachers, and my fellow friends. I, Drishti, feel honored to have been given the opportunity to speak.
Feel honored to have been given the opportunity to speak for the motion or against the motion, whatever topic is given. You can mute yourself. Fine. So in the beginning, you will be wishing or greeting the audience, esteemed judges, if it's a competition. If it's not a competition, just for the sake of doing debate is going on, then you will not use. But most of the times, it is a debate is considered as one of the competitions because favor and against views are presented. So esteemed judges, honorable guests, respected teachers, worthy principal and all, and my dear fellow friends. So I, Drishti of class plus one, feel honored to have been given the opportunity to speak. Now you can also write to voice my opinion. Rather than using the word speak, you can say, I would like to voice my opinion in favor of the motion. Fine. Should whatever topic is given to you, in or against the motion. Fine. In that way. Then after that, better second paragraph, body. This is the main paragraph, means main answer. Always begin with the meaning of the topic in explanation. In one or two lines, discuss the topic, then start quoting the issue, and you have to follow the sequence. It is possible that you have too many points, you have a lot of varied points, but choose the best ones in the beginning, fine? And explain at least two lines each about the points. Make sure your clarity of thought should be there, and unambiguously you have to. Unambiguously means there should not be vagueness. Aisa na ho ki kuch samajh mein na aaye. It should be clear. Then solution. Next paragraph will be including the, like awareness. It can be about laws. It can be about campaigns. It can be about any data given, fine, using a quote. So many ways are there to suggest solutions. Excuse me. Then conclusion. This part clarifies the statement and stance along with thanking the audience. So you will be thanking the audience for being patient listeners, and this paragraph needs to be very precise, very short. Clear? In that way. So you can end your conclusion and this debate with a quote also. Now please see the marking scheme in which your content carries 4 marks, opening and addressing the audience carries 1 mark, introduction, grammatical accuracy, coherence, relevance of, means connectivity of ideas should be there. So 10 marks in total. Clear? Some general points are there. When you start writing the debate, you know what you need to do is firstly write down all the points, one or two per point at the back of your answer sheet, wherever rough sheet is there. You just think of the words, okay, I will be writing about these points, so that when you start writing the debate, you do not miss any important point. Fine. And then grammatical accuracy and spelling should be correct. Adequate number of lines and paragraphs, 3 to 4 hona chahiye. It should look neat and clean. Underlining is very important. Main points ko highlight karo by underlining it. Okay. And always, you know, learn some general quotes. Now, how you will get quotes? Because when we start writing debate, we forget that which quote to be written. So you basically learn some quotes on hard work, learn some quotes on, you can say, burning issues of society. Like you can talk about child labor, you can talk about more use of technology, fine. Then women empowerment. Then debate can be about online education, offline education, online mode is better or offline better. That can be one debate, fine. So general quotes you have to remember. Presentation is very important, and you need to read a lot to get ideas on writing a debate, fine. And please have major environmental, political, social issues, because debate always come about such kind of issues only. So you should have ample in ideas, information about these current issues, political issues, social issues, and major environmental issues. Fine? Clear? So now please open your notebooks. We will be writing value points. Clear? We will be writing some value points. First of all, means the points to be kept in mind while writing a debate. The right logical order I'm going to write here, okay? First of all, you can start with a quote. I'm using star over here. You can use any bullet. Start with a quote or quotation. Fine. Then after that, introduce yourself that I, Drishti of class plus 1B, feel immense pleasure to speak on the topic. Introduce yourself. Fine. This is the first paragraph, beta. Fine. Very first paragraph will be containing this information. Start with a quote, introduce yourself. Greet the audience. Greet means wish. In audience, you have seen already esteemed jury members or judges. Fine. Then if it's a school or college, then you can write director, principal, teachers in that way. Announcement of the topic. Announce the topic. Specifically, you have to mention whether favor or against. And very important thing is do not change the topic. Suppose you get the topic online education is offline education is better than online education. Okay. So this is the topic. So you will write that I, Drishti of class plus 1B, stand in front of you to voice my opinion in favor of the topic. Offline education is better than online education. Fine. So you are going to, obviously you will write that offline is much better. If you want to write against the topic, you will not change the topic of the debate. You cannot write that offline education is not good. Fine. In that way, or online education is better. You cannot change. You will just write, I'm going to voice my opinion against the topic. Offline education is better than online education. Jo bhi topic aaya hai, as it is, you will use. You will not distort the topic, but you will mention whether favor or against and choose the, you can say supporting ideas in that. Sometimes children write that I'm going to write in favor of the topic or niche against ke point likhte jaate hain. Sometimes they mention that they are going to speak against the topic or niche favor kiya hota hai. So that will be a big cross on your sheet. Make sure if you have written favor, then you will favor the topic. If you have written against, then you will write points supporting against the topic. Okay. Then beta, this is your first paragraph. Now what to write in second paragraph? Second paragraph is the main paragraph where all the, you can say, content starts. First of all, explain the topic in two lines that on which you're going to write points. Then support your ideas with factual information. You add some facts, fine, some data, some evidences, so that the audience should be convinced that whatever you are saying in the debate is correct. Clear? So you should add some facts into it, some data into it. Use rhetorical device once, only once, not twice. Now, what is this rhetoric device? Anybody can tell me? I have already discussed ye humne kara hua ek baar beginning mein. After so many days, we're doing this. Anybody knows? What is rhetoric device? Just raise your hand, beta. Anjali, do you know? Yes or no? Nahi aata, bol do no, ma'am. So what? At least participate. Yes, Aditi, if you know what is rhetoric device, Diljeet.
Yes.
Yes, beta, what
yes,
is it?
Yes, ma'am. I'm like poetic device, just say alliteration.
No. Anaphora. No. बिल्कुल भी नहीं. Guess work नहीं चलेगा. You can mute yourself, Anjali, please. Mute yourself, beta. Mute yourself. Yes, Divnur has raised hand. Divnur, tell us.
Ma'am, it is when the speaker asks question to the audience and answers it himself.
Yes, very good. So in this rhetoric device, speaker poses a question to the audience and the speaker himself gives the answer. Okay. Yes, Drishti, correct. Chat box mein likh rahe ho. That's correct. Fine. So rhetoric device is that in which we pose a question to the audience like, are you aware that how online education is ruining the future of our children? Or fine, if you are against it, are you aware that how online education is benefiting the children who are feeling low these days, how they are getting benefits of online education? Already pandemic has made them sit into the houses, and when they have access to the online education, they can at least have interaction with their teachers. There is a change in their lives. They can interact to someone in this era of social distancing. Fine. So this is the benefit. You have to give the answer also. You pose the question and you answer itself. Clear? That is rhetoric device. Then after that, beta, while writing the data, support your ideas with factual information, use rhetoric device, use jargons. Anybody knows? Ye bhi humne point kara hua hai. Jargons kya hote hain? A particular set of words are there for each language. If I use the words keyboard, mouse, motherboard, fine, C++, anything related to what comes to your mind, computer students immediately guess it. I'm talking about computer language, fine. So there are particular words for one particular group of, you can say one particular language. Then these words, if I say alliteration, anaphora, fine, then metaphor, simile, immediately you guess that all are literary devices from English literature. So we have jargons, means set particular words related to particular language. Now jargons of debate are, you have to present your idea in a very strong way and you have to use particular set of jargons. I agree to the point that I disagree with my fellow opponent. According to my viewpoint, as per my opinion, fine, means you have to use, you have to present your ideas in a very strong way. Clear? According to my viewpoint, I agree, I disagree, as per my opinion, as my fellow opponent said, fine, in that way you keep on addressing. These are the set vocabulary for debate only. If you will not be using these particular words, which are meant for jargons only, these phrases should be there. Fine. I strongly oppose this motion. Add karte jao isme aur. I strongly agree. I strongly disagree. I strongly oppose the quote given by my fellow opponent about this. Fine. So these are the set particular words which should be there in a debate. So by using jargons, by using once only rhetoric device, by providing facts and data and discuss the problem. The topic or idea, aapke jo bhi idea hai favor mein, or problem, whatever it is, depending upon the topic. Keeping all these points in mind, discuss the topic, idea, or problem in detail in second paragraph. Okay. Now let's talk about third paragraph now. In third paragraph, you will again give suggestions. Conclude your viewpoint. By quoting someone, by giving some quotes of some famous personality or any other quote, if it is not said by any famous personality, any general quote. And then at the end, at last, when all the paragraphs are done, last mein segregate karke likhoge, fourth paragraph jisko keh dete ho, but this is not fourth paragraph actually. You can also split your ideas. Suppose if you have some more points in debate, you can split this paragraph into two also. Means maximum four paragraphs can also be there. Minimum three should be there in debate. Fine. So if maximum four, minimum three is the requirement. Then thanks for being patient listener. Thanks the audience. Full stop. Fine. So this also is part of the format, thanking the audience. Okay. So we have these, you can say topics, clear? And have you noted down, beta? Show me a notebook. Dikhaiye zara, kis kis ne likha? Let me see. I'll share the screen also. Topic discuss karenge then koi. Show me your notebooks. I will see kaun likh raha hai. Raghav Dhawan. Very good. First one to show the notebook. What about others? Divnur Kaur. Very good. Then next. Anjali is also going to show us. Yes, very good, beta. This is the way you are self, you can say realization is going on that we have to do it for ourselves. Bahut sare bacche wo class attend karte hain, but for the sake of attending. Aditi has also written, very good. So I am naming and appreciating so that you know the value of those children, value of studies being recognized by many children. But what about others? Those who just joined for the sake of attendance. Once you have not shown me any notebook, Japan Preet. Aditi, I have seen you. You showed it. That's okay. Naman Preet, notebook kahan pe hai? Diksha, Ishnoor, Drishti, Mitali. No notebook you have shown to me. So hum taken for granted nahi le sakte. Koi cheez pehle kari hui hai. I need not do this. Aise sun rahe ho, baith ke, late ke. No, nahi sun rahe ho, just for the sake of connecting, it will be your loss at the end of the day. Then do not expect more marks from us. If you are a regular learner, only then you can get marks. So let's see if we can get some. See. One sample I'm going to show you. But this is not the right topic, social media and its effects. This is not, this is a speech only. This is not debate. Debate should be like that in which a topic is, this is the debate. Now you can see, now please note down this topic. This you will do. Ye aap apne notebook mein karoge. This is the topic, fine? So write down the topic. Academic excellence is the only requirement for a successful career. Academic excellence is the only requirement for a successful career. So this is the topic. Let's discuss that. I'm not going to read it from here. I'll be asking you only. Clear? Now you have noted down the topic. Jaldi se topic note kariye. Academic excellence is the only requirement for a successful career. Academic excellence is the only requirement for a successful career. This is the topic of debate. So there was some connectivity issue. That's why the problem is coming. Yes, Beta. I won't be sharing the screen now. So our topic is academic excellence is the only way. Education excellence, sorry, is the only way to, let me check the topic first. The topic was academic excellence is the only requirement for a successful career. Okay. This is the topic. Please start giving your view. Yes, Beta, again, connectivity problem is there. So if you can hear me. Yes. Diljeet.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Beta, tell the point that whether you are in favor of this topic or against, that academic excellence is the only sign to your successful career.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible.
Just give your viewpoint on the topic which we have just discussed. Abhi maine aapko screen share kiya.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible.
To whom am I audible then? Raise your hand.